and Pennsylvania and Virginia, don't think land. Think corporation.
Another question. Now, because I've been seeing, I got a letter from State of Delaware, Department of Justice, but I've also heard Justice Department.
Mm-hmm.
Two different things.
Yes.
Justice Department and Department of
yes.
Justice.
Yes. You've got them both?
No, what I'm saying is, when I seen the letter,
mm-hmm.
and I seen that it had the Department of Justice, mm-hmm. I immediately thought to myself, this is not the legitimate federal government.
Well, write a letter, a bill of particulars, mm-hmm. or a writ in nature of discovery for clarification, okay. and ask them for that, let them state it. Because one of the things that they recognize is that that many of us are becoming aware of that. That state of, and then also the name and then the state, also means different things. So you like say city of, or Camden City of Camden, etc. So what you want to do is put them on the spot. And what they have done is actually switch them around sometimes, knowing that you are aware of that. And so they'll do it in maybe three or four different forms to continue to make that confusion. But what I would always do relative to them, if it came to an issue like that, I would issue a bill of particulars or a written nature of discovery and command clarification, lawful clarification of their corporate status and or their national republic status, for the record. And what you do, you make out your own forms for them to fill out. Particularly if something where they can make a command of you for a specific performance, etc. And I think I did something like that in one of the lesson books years ago. You seen something like that? You can make a form out asking them questions. And then so wherever you may be confused, because remember they're servants.
Right.
And then you can also have a qualification statement at the bottom if such areas of your political allegiance are not clear, consider yourself voided on this point or of any authority, etc. And then when you do that also in a written instrument, that also becomes an attachment to whatever issue that you're dealing with, particularly if it's a lawful or legal issue and is not separate. And so you know, you also CC them. So I would take an instrument like that, write to those departments, but always make sure you send to the governor also. And the reason you send to the governor, because he's a Mason. And he got a fez, too. All right? And he's like what you would call someone who's wearing two hats. So he's got to wear fez for the great seal. Then he's got to wear his just regular robe for the corporation. And it's sort of like what side you come up. And so the deal is, if you don't acknowledge yourself, he won't. Because his obligation is first to the corporate state. Although, truthfully, his first obligation is to the Great Seal. But remember, they overthrew the United States Republic. So if the people don't demand it, he's not going to stand up. All right, so like things that the Sharif should be doing only in his jurisdiction, they'll have ordinary policemen doing. Mm-hmm. For expediency, which is also a violation of law.
Our sheriff seems to be reduced to just going around seizing people's property. That's what I mean.
Well, he's working for the mortgage companies.
Right. All we ever see is him attaching documents to people's houses.
Well, again, most of those people. Yes, but look at this. Most of those people that he sends documents or writs of execution, mostly what they're issuing, have deeds. Are people aware of allodial titles? They're on the assumption that they have ownership. Am I correct?
Right. My point is, I very seldom see him enforcing law.
No, because then
like he's restricted to.
Now you want to look at again on a national class action suit, as well as we talk about if we're going to get the people conscious enough to issue something to the Hague. Mm-hmm. Is that's dereliction of duty, isn't it?
Right.
Now remember, when you make any claim against those persons, always list fraud, because fraud has no statute of limitation. Then subtitle all the violations, all right? And don't miss the fraud. And then you want to talk about racketeering, too. And so, and then you, if a sheriff allows someone to execute certain writs or warrants that is his responsibility to do, and they're really not elected, because remember when they say police officers? That's a lie,
right.
Because they're not elected. officer means an elected person. So it's also misrepresentation, isn't it? So I'm making these points so you can recognize that you have a multiplicity of points by which to start protecting your rights when they start rolling you and rolling your family members.
With regards to the term police officer not being an elected officer, I know that term is created by statute.
It's statutory.
What about the power of the legislature to define its own terms and to give someone...
The power of the legislature is limited by the Constitution, isn't it?
Yes.
Oh, what did you just say?
Well, the question...
No, I'm saying to you, the statement that you said gives an assumption of power and authority and jurisdiction that does not reside with the legislature.
I was referring to a Supreme Court case that I've read,
yes,
which has indicated that the legislatures of the several states, that they have the authority to define their own terms, what are called terms of art. So they can say red means blue and blue means yellow. And so they can say police officer means the people that jump out of the cars and tell you to pull up.
Symbolography. And what does the Supreme Court also say about color of law? Isn't that apparent contradiction? Isn't that apparent color?
Yeah.
Does it stand upon a challenge?
No.
What does Supreme Law say? No matter how long a thing or a law, purportedly law, is maintained or sustained, that at all times, if it's in contradiction with the Constitution, it has neither the power or the quality of law. However, most people don't object, do they? So if you tell them something that's absolutely in contradiction to the Constitution and still objecting, they go along with, you know, the judge said that, you know, peanut butter sandwiches on Thursday are illegal if the sheriff says so. Well, where did he derive that authority? Do you see what I'm trying to say to you?
Yes.
So what I'm saying to you is back to the same principle that Tom Jefferson, Ben Franklin, George Washington told the people before to that sister. You now have a republic if you're willing to keep it. So the point is, if you're not going to stand for the Constitution in the face of contradiction and you accept it, you're accepting a jurisdictional contract, aren't you? Under color of law. So that makes them colored people and it makes you colored people. And if you're colored, does law apply to you? Yes. Colored regulations. Or the Negro codes. You have a right to agree to that. You also have a right to object. So the obligation of all citizens is to do what? To uphold the Constitution of the Republic, United States, Central North America. If there's any laws, now deal with Article 6 of the Constitution. Read that out. And this is relative to, quote unquote, the state's legislatures. Now, open your ears on this.
Article 6. All debts contracted and engagements entered into before the adoption of this Constitution shall be as valid against the United States under this Constitution as under the Confederation. This Constitution and the laws of the United States which shall be made in pursuance thereof, and all treaties made, or which shall be made, under the authority of the United States, shall be the supreme law of the land, and the judges in every state shall be bound thereby. Anything in the Constitution or laws of any state to the contrary notwithstanding. The senators and representatives before mentioned, and the members of the several state legislatures, and all executive and judicial officers, both of the United States and of the several states, shall be bound by oath or affirmation to support this Constitution, but no religious test shall ever be required as a qualification to any office or public trust under the United States.
So what did I tell you? Just what I'm telling you. Now, are they bound to that Constitution or they can make up their own game? Uh-huh. So if you don't hold them to that and you waive your rights and they take them because you want to throw them down because you listen to what somebody said that contradicts that, then they say any laws of any of the states, etc., to the